In today's reverse diet update for my client Vivyen, she has started creatine, so I talk about how the reverse is going and what you should expect with regards to weight gain when starting creatine. Hey, this is Colin DeWitt. If you want to master your metabolism and create forever results, start now by subscribing and click on that bell notification so you don't miss anything. All right, this update should be pretty short and sweet, but there are some valuable things I do want to talk about with regards to Vivyen's reverse, including the introduction of creatine. If you've been keeping up with the series, you know that we haven't really made any changes in the last couple of months and that she's been in a pretty steady surplus, which is what we've been looking for now as she tries to focus more on building muscle. Based on her body weight, we want to keep her weight gain to around a third to a half a pound per week on average to make sure that she's sufficiently in a surplus to optimally build muscle, but not so much that we're causing an unnecessary amount of fat gain. And since we last left off at week 30, if we look at week 31, she saw an increase of 0.37 pounds for the week. So a pretty good spot considering what we want to accomplish. But one thing to note about this week, as noted, she did start creatine. So the date you see in blue is the date she started creatine. And anytime you start taking creatine, there's a pretty decent chance that you're going to start storing more water in your muscle cells and therefore see an increase on the scale. Which that's what, about reason 732 why we can't get too stressed out about the scale, and there's a lot of reasons we can see it go up and down, and not all movement is always bad. In fact, this weight gain is actually good because your muscles are holding more water, and that's only going to help you, but it is something to consider because it's pretty common to see maybe about 1 to 3 pounds of weight increase from introducing creatine into your system. And to be perfectly honest, I think pretty much every lifter should be on creatine unless you have some sort of medical condition like some kind of kidney dysfunction where you wouldn't want to take it. It's easily the most tried and true, the most research-backed supplement there is, and there's practically an endless amount of evidence to support that it helps with muscle size, strength, power, and work capacity. And that goes double for vegans or anybody who doesn't get a lot of meat in their diet, because you're not going to get a lot of creatine from your diet sources, and I've seen some pretty incredible results in vegans who start taking creatine. So the real question is, why wouldn't you take it? And the only real answer anybody can ever seem to give is they don't want to see an increase on the scale, but you have to understand that's literally just another number and it has absolutely nothing to do with body fat. Anyway, I typically find it takes about 1 to 2 weeks for the muscles to saturate and to show up on a scale if it's going to, and that's basically what we see with Vivyen here. As we look at week 32, she saw a bigger increase of about 0.72 pounds for that week, but we have to factor in creatine. Now Vivyen is actually close to testing her 1 rep maxes here, and she mentioned that she was feeling crazy strong this week with all of her lifts. Now I'm not going to sit here and say it was all because of creatine, but it certainly didn't hurt. But of course, her diligence to the plan, being out of a deficit for a long time and into a small surplus and all that type of stuff, did most of the heavy lifting, so to speak, but the creatine certainly didn't hurt. And that is something else that I wanted to talk about here, because all these lifts that you're seeing are conservative maxes for her as we get ready to do the actual testing, but all three lifts are lifetime PRs for her. I've talked about it before and I'm going to continue to talk about it. It is so important to focus on things like performance-based goals when going through a reverse diet so you don't end up going crazy just focusing on how you want to lose weight. So appreciate the things like increased strength and energy, and do like Vivyen has done and make all the gains during the process. And I'm really excited to finish off this block with her and see what happens when we go through the mock meet. And let's all take a moment to give a huge congrats to Vivyen for hitting the big plate club on bench press. Just look at that reaction. This is what this lifestyle is all about, enjoying the process and making yourself proud. Anyway, as I'm sure you figured, we're going to hold her macros steady here as she continues to be in a bit of a surplus, and we'll just continue to hold them as long as her body is appropriately responding, which, as I mentioned last week, I have a feeling is going to be quite a while. By the way, if you want to discover how to build muscle without storing extra body fat, make sure you check out this video and I'll walk you through how fast you should increase your calories depending on your goals. If you're new to the channel, consider subscribing, and I will see you next time.